G'day, welcome to Evention. Today, I'm gonna teach you the intricacies of sitting the trot.
What are you doing? Why are you fake sitting the trot? Where's your horse? You don't even have a horse out here. Okay, today on Evention, we're gonna help you sit the trot. Go get your horse, go on.
G'day guys, and welcome back to Evention. Thanks for bearing with us on our 2-week hiatus while we were getting settled into our new farm in Cochranville, Pennsylvania. But we're so excited to get started with a new spring summer season. And straight off the bat, we're gonna tackle a hard one, how to sit the trot a bit better. Now let's go through a couple of the common issues with sitting the trot. The first and most obvious one is bouncing around up there like a sack of potatoes. We gotta look at why that happens. There's a couple of common things with our position that can make this harder, but you gotta remember too that not every horse is the same. Some are harder to sit than others, but we're gonna try and focus on the things that we can control. First one is getting our grip down nice and low and around the horse. If we try and grip with the knee, we're gonna bounce more. Second thing is to try and protect ourselves from that bouncing. Sometimes we like to get into our chair seat where we sit on the fleshy part of our bum. And when we get back there, that only makes the bouncing worse, and generally our leg comes forward and it doesn't look as nice, and we're not in as better position as we can be. Last but not least is when we're getting all that bouncing energy coming up through our bodies, is not letting our head bobble around like you saw me do in the intro. So we're going to give you a couple of simple exercises to help improve these things, but first let's go to a quick Schrammo shout out. Today's shout out goes to Equine Voices Rescue and Sanctuary. These guys are rescuing horses from slaughter. You can check out the great work that they do, including meeting their mascot Gulliver at www.equinevoices.org. Welcome back, guys. My first tip is to gradually create the sitting trot. Once you start bouncing in the sitting trot, it's very hard to regain your seat back. So by taking your time and starting in a much slower trot, hopefully you can establish your seat and slowly but surely move up from there. Obviously, the more energy we create in the trot, the more energy we have to sit on. So by starting slower, we can give our body some time to move with the horse. Some things that we want to be thinking about whilst we're sitting on the horse is keeping that weight down in our heel, keeping our shoulders nice and tall, and getting the feeling like we're sinking down into the saddle. Very good. Okay, let's move on to our second exercise, but first, an Evention tip of the day.
Hi guys, I'm Stephanie, and for my Evention tip of the day, next time you're taking your bridle off your horse, just take it off and give it a quick dunk in some water before all the crud has time to dry, and you'll save plenty of time on your next tack cleaning adventure. Good luck.
Welcome back, guys. Before we get started with these training tips, a common sense alert. These exercises are designed to improve your position, and they're not really suitable for inexperienced or flighty horses. Today, we're using Jimmy's experienced horse. I'm holding the lunge lead, and we're in an enclosed space. So always approach these with caution. Anyways, let's get started. So my next exercise, I've taken away the stirrups from Jimmy, and I'm going to get her to practice sitting the trot without the stirrups. Now, let's explain the purpose of this. We're trying to establish our seat and not grip in the wrong places. Now, a couple of things you may notice when you go into the sitting trot whilst without stirrups. Let's do it, Jimmy. the first thing you may feel is that you are pointing your toes. Show me how it's done, Jimmy. Keep him trotting. And what that points out to us is that we're gripping with our knee, which is the total opposite of what we're trying to achieve here. So imagine that you do have stirrups, bringing your toe up and pushing your heel down and really trying to get a feel for that saddle and sitting in it and balancing yourself. Another common thing you may see with this is that as you get unstable, you're gonna try and hold the reins and use them for balance. We've got to try and keep those soft and just take a breath and feel the movement of the saddle. Now this is tough, and make sure you do lots of walk breaks. There's no point pulling a hammy when you're trying this one. Take a walk, Jimmy. All right, let's move on to our next difficult exercise. Okay guys, on to our final training tip. Again, use your common sense here. So we're gonna take the reins away now, and what we're gonna try and achieve by this is counteract that constant want to balance on the front end, which will make us have to use our seat and legs more effectively. So we've got them tied in a knot there that's nice and steady. It's there if we need it in the case of an emergency, but we're not relying on it, and we're gonna try and steer the horse with our legs and our seat. So, what do you do with your arms? Well, you can do the old aeroplane arms like we did when we were learning how to ride. Personally, I prefer to tuck them in behind the arch of my back to help encourage me to sit up nice and tall and not lean from side to side. All right, Jimmy, pop him in the trot. So we've started out with letting Jimmy have her stirrups. Bellamy doesn't quite know what's going on. And so we're going to try and establish our seat and our sitting trot without balancing using our hands and our reins. Good. And again, pop him in the trot. Now this is hard work, and we have to take our time to make sure that we're sitting correctly and not developing any new bad habits. And you can use a combination of not having your stirrups and not having your reins, and do this every now and then just to give yourself a little bit of a tune-up. And hopefully, we can improve our sitting trot position. All right, take a walk. Good. Good boy, and give him a pat. All right, guys, we hope you've learned something today. Hopefully next time you won't be bouncing around like a sack of potatoes. See you next week.